Good afternoon. I'm Valérie Cabanès. I'm a legal expert in international law. I'm one of the spokesperson of the End Ecocide movement, promoting the rights of nature and asking to recognize the crime of ecocide as the fifth international crime against peace. I'm a writer too. I wrote a book in French called Un nouveau droit pour la Terre, translated in English, called Rights for Planet Earth, and a book called Homo Natura. What I would like to say, following what Lisa explained, is that if our capacity to be conscious of ourselves has led us insidiously to imagine ourselves as external to reality, then this individual consciousness will have to move not towards a group consciousness, an experience that we already know and often oppose, but rather towards a universal consciousness in which everyone accepts to be a mere note in this great symphony of life and beyond that the cosmos, while staying rooted to the ground. Our consciousness and knowledge of life, our ability to admire and understand it, should have taught us how to honor it for what it is. We must learn to see life as a whole. If we had only one role to play, it would be the role of protectors. Faced with the perils that threaten us, we must open ourselves to tolerance and solidarity. We cannot just hope for it, we must also embody it. The philosopher Jiddu Krishnamurti explained it differently. Revolution must begin with you and me. That revolution, that individual transformation, can take place only when we understand relationship, which is the process of self-knowledge. And this can only be done by a deep awareness of the principle of interdependence that binds us all, which binds us to the earth and all other living beings. We should embody a deeply egalitarian worldview in the sense that everyone is recognized in his vital function and everyone knows that he or she is necessary to others. If, like the hummingbird, each of us can intervene to extinguish the great fire, it is as well essential to connect us in order to act in a universal way. This is the synchronicity of our action that will bring about change. The more we are to promote and protect the rights of nature, the more we will have confidence in our collective capacities, the more we will be able to act as a great wave. Moreover, by putting our energy at the service of life and not by particular interest, we should feel much more in alignment with ourselves and with the universe. If our individual consciousness awakens, it nourishes and transforms our collective and conscious, which Jung and Schopenhauer have called the unus mundus. Man, when he thinks himself, also thinks the world and becomes it. The Persian philosopher Rumi summed it up simply: you're not a drop of water in the ocean, you're the whole ocean in a drop of water. This holistic thought is common to many spiritual traditions and find its source in the wisdom of the indigenous people. It has allowed them to find their rightful place and live for millennia in harmony with nature. Let me give you an example that you may not have heard about to end. In New Caledonia, which is still under French sovereignty, at least up to next year, the Kanak community of the Loyalty Islands, their customary chiefs and the elected representative of the community have recognized in their environmental code adopted in April 2016 the unitary principle of life, according to which man belongs to the natural environment that surrounds it and conceives its identity in the elements of this natural environment, which constitute the founding principle of the Kanak society. As they explain, for the Kanak, there is no difference between man and his environment. He is the sea, the earth. they are now reflecting on the elements of nature, that could be granted with a legal personality. So let's do the same together during these 2 days. Thank you.